I'm Courtney Alexander. We're currently at UCSF in San Francisco, and I'm a postdoctoral research scientist. I'm studying adult stem cells and epigenetic modification, which are changes to DNA, and how that affects how the stem cells behave. The questions we're looking at in our lab was just a lot of toothpaste stuff. You're not going to die from loss of teeth, but it really affects your quality of life if you have to wear dentures. So being able to provide someone with a new tooth from their own tissue is really exciting and really will just help people all over. It's really exciting to think that, you know, we're just a small piece of the puzzle, the big puzzle, but that something that we do here can eventually help somebody's quality of life long term. I didn't really know I was going to become a biologist till I was an undergrad, and even then it was late when I was an undergrad. I started off studying biological anthropology because I thought fossils were really cool. And I really liked studying how you could notice changes in the past by just looking at bones and changes in the bones. But as I studied more, I got a chance to work in a laboratory looking at the biology of bones. And I realized what I really found interesting was living bones, how a living bone maintains itself and grows and gets the shape it does. And I think it's one of the coolest organs in the body because it's a living structure. And without your bones, we would look different. We'd just be a pile of goo on the floor. So they're very important. So I decided to further study biology and went to graduate school where I studied developmental biology, specifically craniofacial development. You know, you start from just a bunch of cells and then somehow they're given signals and then they form the shape of your face. And everyone's face is a little different, and if you look across animal species, they have such wide variety of skulls and bones, but you know, when you're embryos, it all looks the same. So it's just very interesting to know the biology of that and how, you know, the patterning happens. But also, craniofacial defects are one of the highest congenital birth defects that happen. So understanding how your skull and bones form is also important for developing therapeutic strategies. So I was looking at the, you know, skeleton in more of a developmental biology context, so from embryonic. But I got interested in the stem cell aspect of it because, you know, that's maintaining an adult skeleton, an adult form. So looking at the adult stem cells in bones and teeth is a way to develop strategies that can help repair, you know, bone defects and tooth loss in adults. On a day-to-day basis, I'm doing a lot of molecular biology techniques. So we're doing a lot of staining, looking for markers of specific genes to see where they're expressed in certain tissues. I'm also doing some biochemistry, trying to look at protein specifically and how those interact with one another. What I like about science is it's coming up with solutions to problems. And that's just a way to, it's very creative, and for every failure, you learn something new from it. And it's not really a failure because you learned why it didn't work. So it's just refining how to solve problems. And when you do solve a problem, it's really exciting. And that can make up for all those months where nothing was working. One of the important things is you really have to be passionate about what you're studying, because otherwise science can be kind of a slog, and you really have to care about your subject matter. Also, it's really important to get some hands-on experience, because reading about science in a textbook is a lot different than actually doing science. So it's definitely important to go and get that experience. Being good at science, you do have to use a lot of creativity, because most of the questions you're asking have never been asked before. So you have to come up with the question, and then you have to come up with how to answer that question. And that involves a lot of research and just trial and error a lot of times. So yeah, it is a really creative process that I think gets overlooked a lot, because you have to come up with these new ideas, and they're brand new. And that's also exciting, because anytime you find something, you know you're the first person who's found that. And maybe it's just, again, a needle in a haystack, but it's your needle, and you came up with that. And it's really exciting and cool.